Hello everyone, welcome back to the channel. I am Nikhil Kumar. Today we are doing one of the most important Kubernetes setup, that is migrating your existing Ingress NGINX application to a Gateway API using NGINX Gateway Fabric. This is video 5 in my Gateway API series. If you haven't watched my initial 4 videos where we installed Gateway API, created Gateway, created HTTPRoute and configured both manual and automated TLS, I highly recommend to watch those videos first, because in this video, we are building on that particular knowledge. So in this demo, we will take a real application which is being exposed using Ingress NGINX, and then we will fully migrate it to a modern Gateway API configuration. Let's begin with our starting point, the application which is currently running using Ingress NGINX. This will be our source system from where we will start the migration. Alright, let's start with what we already have running in our cluster. This is our existing setup using Ingress NGINX, and this is exactly what we are going to migrate to Gateway API. So first of all, let's check the application status. So for that, we can run kubectl get pods, and we can see that my NGINX pod is working fine. This is the app that is currently being exposed through our Ingress. So let's check the service, because Ingress internally routes traffic to the service. So kubectl get service. Here we can see my-nginx service is being created. It's a cluster IP service, and the Ingress controller forwards external traffic to this particular service. Now check the Ingress. So kubectl get Ingress. As we can see, there is one Ingress controller already created with the name ngin-ingress. And here we can see the ports, that is 80 and the 443. That means it works for HTTP and HTTPS both. So let's describe this resource. So kubectl describe Ingress and the Ingress name. It has a host. In my case, it's master01, and it has a rule for path, that is slash, routes a traffic to service, that is my-nginx. This is the classic common Ingress setup that most Kubernetes clusters uses today. So let's test this as well. So using curl hyphen k https master01, and we can see that NGINX application is working fine via Ingress controller. As we can see, the HTTPS working for the Ingress controller as well. The traffic come through the Ingress controller, TLS is handled using the secret we created, and the request is finally reaches to our NGINX application. So this is our baseline, a fully working Ingress based application. Now let's talk about the migration plan. Before we start the hands-on on migration, I want you to clearly understand what is changing when we move from Ingress to a Gateway API. On the left hand side, we have a traditional Ingress, which is a very monolithic object. A single YAML does everything: your routes, host names, backend services, TLS configuration, rewrite annotation, and lots of controller specific behavior. So the Ingress become a big block of configuration, and the moment you add multiple apps or the multiple teams, things get messy very quickly. Now on the right hand side, we have the Gateway API, which follows a modular and modern architecture. Everything is broken into clear, independent components. It has a Gateway class. It defines which controller will implement the Gateway. Then we have a Gateway. It defines the front-end listeners like port, TLS and the IPs. And it has a HTTP route, which defines the backend routing like paths, host and the services. And instead of controller specific annotation, we now use standardized features and the filters. So the idea is simple. Ingress is equal to one big file, and Gateway is like a small, clean, modular files with clear responsibilities. This separation is what makes Gateway API much easier to manage in production, especially when you have a multiple apps, multiple teams, or complex routing logic. So we are not deleting the application, the service, or the TLS secret. We are only replacing the Ingress layer with the Gateway API layer. Alright, now that architecture is clear, let's jump into the actual migration. Before we start writing any YAML, let's look at the exact migration step we are going to follow. We will create a step-by-step process for the migration plan from Ingress to the Gateway API so that you can use that particular approach in the production environments. The first step is export existing Ingress. We first take the current Ingress YAML and understand how it works. The host, the path, and the TLS certificate and the backend services. This is our starting point. Next, we will create a Gateway resource. This replaces the entry point part of the ingress, basically the ports, protocols, and the TLS termination. Then we are going to create a HTTP route. Here we move the routing rules from the ingress into a separate HTTP route resource. This is where we define hostname and the backend services. Then we need to attach the TLS to the gateway. In the gateway API, TLS doesn't sit inside the HTTP route. It always lives on the gateway's listener. So we attach the same TLS secret that the ingress is using right now. Next, we are going to test it. This is very important because ingress and gateway API can run together. So we test everything with a zero downtime. And at last, we are going to remove the old ingress. So once we are fully confident that routing works through the gateway API, we finally delete the old ingress. So these are the 6 essential steps you can follow to migrate any ingress-based application to gateway API. Whether you are working in dev, staging, or even a strict production environment, if you follow this 6-step plan, you can easily migrate your application from ingress to a gateway API. Now that the plan is clear, let's start the actual hands-on migration. So before we write any new YAML, let's extract and understand our existing ingress. This is something you always do in a real migration. So first of all, we need to get the YAML for the currently working ingress controller. So for that, first of all, we get the name. So kubectl get ingress. So the name is nginx-ingress. So to get the YAML for that, we can use kubectl get ingress and the ingress name. And we need to specify the old hyphen ingress dot YAML. So the file got created. So if I open this file, old hyphen ingress dot YAML, I missed hyphen o YAML in this command. So let me update that. So hyphen ingress hyphen o YAML. So if I open this file again, so this is the complete manifest file which is being used by the ingress controller. Now let me break it down for you so that you can easily understand the ingress controller and you can easily migrate it to a gateway API as well. So if we come here in the specification, we can see under the rule we have a host. That is the host name of our server. That is master01. So we will move this to a HTTP route. Then we have a path that is for the slash and specifying the backend services as well. So this becomes a rule inside a HTTP route. Then we have a TLS block where we are specifying the host name and the secret information. So this moves from ingress to a gateway listener. And if we go above, we can see the annotations. Ingress uses annotations heavily, but the gateway API replaces this with standardized feature. For this basic migration, we don't need a rewrite one. So now we know exactly what needs to be moved from where. So let's start by creating a gateway API object. So the gateway replaces the ingress controller entry point. So let me create a file for that. Create one folder, migration ingress to gateway API. And let me go inside this. And here I'm going to create all the files for this particular demo. Before we continue, just a quick note, the gateway API with NGINX Gateway Fabric is already installed in this particular cluster. So if we want to check that, so we can run this command, that is kubectl get all, and under the namespace, that is nginx-gateway. And we can see all the pods and the services for the NGINX Gateway Fabric is running fine. And I have already covered the full installation and the configuration step for the TLS in my previous video. So you can watch that first if you need the basic understanding of the gateway API and the TLS configuration in the gateway API. Now let's move on to a gateway creation part. So let me create a file. So vi-gateway.yml. So this is our gateway file. So let's understand this file in a simple way. At the top, we are creating a gateway resource. So we are placing it into a default namespace. The important part here is the gateway class name, that is NGINX. So this tells Kubernetes to use the NGINX Gateway Fabric controller, which we already installed earlier using the Helm chart. Then we define two listeners. These are the entry points for our application. The first one is for the HTTP. Here we are specifying the protocol that is HTTP, the port that is 80, and we are allowing HTTP routes only from the same namespace. So this is the most secure and the beginner friendly option. The second is HTTPS listener. In this, we are using the protocol HTTPS and the port number 443. And here we are setting up the TLS to terminate, which means the gateway decrypts the HTTPS before forwarding the traffic. And here we reference the same TLS secret that our Ingress was using, that is my-app-tls. And remember, in the gateway API, the TLS termination always happens on the gateway, not inside the HTTP route. So this is the correct place to configure the certificates. So let me apply this. So we can use kubectl apply -f gateway.yaml. So the gateway got created. So if we run kubectl get gateway, so we can see the gateway got created and we can see the IP address, that is a cluster IP, and we can see that program is equivalent to true. Now let's see the service for that. So if we run kubectl get service, we can see it internally created a two service. One is the my nginx, that is a cluster IP service, and another is a node port service, that is a nginx gateway nginx, that is a node port services which exposes the port 80 and the 443. During the migration, we will use this node port service for the testing purpose. And I have already covered this particular thing in very much detail if you want to understand how to configure the TLS certificate using the manual or the cert manager. So I will add a link in the description, so I would suggest you to check it out to get a better understanding that how these particular things works in the gateway API. Now that our gateway is created and fully configured with HTTP and the HTTPS listener, the next step is to migrate the actual routing rules. Basically, everything that was inside the spec under the rules section of the Ingress will now move into a HTTP route. So what I mean that spec rules, so if I open the old Ingress file, here if we see under specification under the rules, we have this particular section where we are specifying the path and the service, that is a backend service to route the traffic. Think of the gateway as a door and the HTTP route as the rulebook that decides how the traffic flow inside. Now let me create a file for the HTTP route. So vi-httpRoute.yaml, and let me update the content here. So this is our HTTP route file. So let me break this down for you. So first of all, we are specifying the metadata, that is a name and the namespace information. So we are going to create this particular HTTP route under the default namespace because our application and the gateway is in the default namespace. Under the specification, we are going to specifying the gateway information, hostname and the rules. The parent ref section attaches this HTTP route to a gateway which we created earlier. So this is similar to the Ingress class name but much more explicit and the flexible. Next, we add a hostname. This comes directly from the Ingress. So whatever host the Ingress was matching, we put the same value here. So this ensures routing only applies for requests coming to this hostname. Then we define the rules. So here we match the slash path using the path prefix, which gives us the same behavior as the Ingress path type. And finally, we point the traffic to the backend service using the backend refs. So this replaces the backend service.name and the backend.service.port from the Ingress file. So this single HTTP route file completely replaces the routing logic of the Ingress. So let me apply this. So kubectl apply -f httpRoute.yaml. So the HTTP route got created. So let's verify that. Kubectl get HTTP route. And we can see the HTTP route got created. And here we can see the hostname information, that is master0fun. Now our gateway API setup is fully in place. The gateway handles the entry point and the HTTP route handles all the routing logic. Now it's time to test everything side by side without touching the Ingress. In production, migration must always be zero downtime. So instead of deleting the Ingress, we test the gateway API while the Ingress is still alive. So let me get the gateway node port. So we can use the kubectl get service, and this is the node port information for that. So here it exposes the port 80 via node port 32708 and 443 port number via 30985 port number. So let's test this one. So curl hyphen k https and the hostname, that is master01, and the port number 30985. And we can see the application is working fine. And if I want to test the same application using the Ingress, so if I run curl -k HTTPS master 01. And from Ingress as well, it's working fine. Now we are ready to switch the traffic to the Gateway API completely. You might be confused that I use the notebook here and it doesn't look good while we are working in the production. So here I use the service type as a notebook while deploying the NGINX Gateway Fabric. But so in the production, you generally use the load balancer as a service type for the NGINX Gateway Fabric. So you don't need to worry about these things in the production environment with the load balancer as a service type. Now, in a real production migration, the final step would be to update the DNS to point to the new gateway entry point. And this could be your cloud load balancer IP, a node IP, or a custom virtual IP address depending on your environment. And once the traffic is flowing smoothly through the Gateway API, we can safely retire the old Ingress. So for that, what we can do, kubectl get Ingress. So this is our Ingress name. Let me delete this. So kubectl delete Ingress. So the Ingress got deleted successfully. And if I run kubectl get gateway, so this is our gateway. And if I run the same command again, now our application is not accessible via Ingress. Now, if we want to test the application or access the application using Gateway API, we can use the same configuration with the notepad and the domain name. And we can see that our application is fully migrated to a Gateway API. And that's it. All your traffic is now flowing through a Gateway API using NGINX Gateway Fabric. But before we end the video, here are some real world tips that I personally follow whenever I migrate applications from Ingress to a Gateway API. So first of all, do not delete the Ingress first. Always test the Gateway API side by side. So this ensures the zero downtime. So in the demo, you just saw. So I didn't delete the Ingress first. I just tested the Gateway API. If it works fine, then only I deleted the Ingress controller. Second is to keep the same TLS secret. This makes the migration seamless because both Ingress and the Gateway API reuse the same certificate. Third is to verify all hostname and the path. Even a small typo in the hostname can break routing. And fourth is to use the cert manager. For real production cluster, always automate certificate renewal. So you can seamlessly automate the certificate creation of the secret via cert manager, and you just need to update the secret information in the gateway file. Fifth is to use multiple HTTP routes. Don't put everything into one giant YAML file. Split route by service or by microservices. Sixth is to move read-write rules or the headers. This should be moved into a Gateway API filter. And do not try to replicate annotation behavior manually. And let last, separate apps by namespace and allowed rules. So this gives the team clean boundaries and avoid accidental routing conflicts. So these are simple but extremely powerful practices. And they will save you a lot of troubleshooting when you manage large Kubernetes cluster. And that completes our full migration from existing Ingress application to a Gateway API. So we analyzed the existing Ingress, created equivalent gateway, created HTTP route, migrated TLS, tested traffic side by side, and retired the old Ingress. If you found this video helpful, hit like, share it with your friends, and subscribe for more content like this. And definitely check the previous video if you want a strong foundation. Thanks for watching. I will see you in the next one.